Quick video about RAM speed today. 3600 versus 2666 stock RAM speed. Does it make much of a difference in Star Citizen? Should in theory, does it? Let's have a look. Okay, so the premise of this is, does RAM speed make much of a difference in Star Citizen? It's obviously completely unoptimized. You can't really benchmark it, but I've had a bash, as you are going to see here. This run that you can see, this basically is what I've done. I've done this 20 times. For first of all, 3600 CL16 RAM. And then I've basically taken off the XMP profile and run the same run through Lawville another 20 times at default speed. So 2666, however many sixes you need there, megahertz. And it's on a Ryzen system, Ryzen 3700. I'm sure with Intel it'll be slightly different, but Ryzen itself definitely is, as lots of people will say, is very hungry for fast RAM. So should it make much of a difference? In theory, it should. There's lots of different benchmarks for different games on the internet, but this one will be for Star Citizen. Now, as you will very much know, if you've been following Star Citizen for long, you can't benchmark it. Basically, it's impossible. So that's the reason I've done 20 isn't enough, but I've done 20 of this exact run just to give it a go, because it is a real, it's not a particularly wise thing to do. Now, about the run, there are variables even within that. So sometimes you will spawn in different hubs within Lawville, some are upstairs, some are downstairs, and you basically, the variation of that will make a difference. Sometimes you get daytime, nighttime, dusk, dawn, all that sort of stuff going on. It doesn't tend to make too much difference from what I can see. But from the data that I'll pop up in a second, you can see huge variation between runs. Once again, just proving that you can't just run something once on Star Citizen and say, that's what FPS I get in this bit. You have to account for the servers and they basically make a huge difference. Okay, so here's the data from the 3600 runs. And you can see there's huge variation between them. Again, the Star Citizen servers and just the general optimization of the game just make a huge difference. The actual mean average for this is 37.4, and yeah, that means nothing really in isolation. You have to pop up the other data. But it's an interesting run, this, because you have got some parts that are definitely CPU slash server bound, and then you've got some parts that are probably more GPU bound. I'm not running particularly quick GPU, it's just the 1070 Ti. So there, it's an interesting run, really. And here, then, you can see the 2666, if I can get that right, average. And the mean is lower, so it's just over 3 FPS lower. So there is a tangible difference, again, over a quite a small sample size, but there is an actual difference between this. Realistically, nobody is running 2666 RAM. Very few are running that on purpose. The thing might be that you might be running it by accident if you've not, if something changed in your BIOS, or you've just forgotten to just put XMP profile on. Okay, and now I'm just going to have a quick look at the rest of the data, just if you're interested. So we've got some 1% lows and 0.1% lows. And generally, it's the same pattern. If you look at whether your eyes are good enough or it's big enough on the screen, the 1% low mean is 22.2 FPS, and the for the 3600 RAM, and the 2666 RAM is 2 FPS lower at 20, and the same with the 0.1% lows, you're losing 2 FPS in those. As you can see, the 0.1 and the 1% lows just, again, highlights just the kind of general stutteriness of Star Citizen there. They're not, if you again looked at another benchmark on a for a different game, any kind of 1% lows or 0.1% lows in those kind of regions, you would be saying that's not good. And yeah, Star Citizen is still obviously nowhere near done and is still in development. So yeah, again, that's just part of where we're at this point. Well, I hope that was slightly interesting. I mean, it's not really, is it? Like 3 FPS. I kind of expected slightly more than that. But there we go. It took a long time, but you know, sometimes it's worth just doing these things just to see. So hopefully it was interesting. The main thing probably is, if you just check that you actually got your right XMP profile set up in your BIOS, make sure you're not running unnecessarily slow, because you are losing performance, which is just not a lot. And really, if you are thinking, oh, the game is stuttery, maybe I'll improve my RAM speed, it's not going to be a huge difference. Again, as always, we are waiting for optimization, we're waiting for server improvements, we're waiting for all sorts of things. You can't really do anything to make Star Citizen run much better on your own. So yeah, if you like that, subscribe, come and follow me on Twitch, and when I get to 100,000 Twitch followers, I'm going to get a tattoo of Chris Roberts' face on my foot.